switch the light off, turn the heating down, buy a more fuel-efficient car. Hardly the most controversial advice for people concerned about the environment. But to Northern Ireland's environment minister, it is part of an insidious propaganda campaign, and he's banned the government's advertising campaign on climate change from broadcasting in the province. And Sammy Wilson's controversial views do not stop there, as our SANS correspondent Tom Clark explains.
It's a government-funded ad campaign aimed at encouraging people to save money and fight climate change by using energy more efficiently.
Yeah, you've gone all green since we got that heating bill, haven't you, Dad?
But the Environment Minister for Northern Ireland, DUP MP Sammy Wilson, has banned the ads from running in his patch, arguing they were made without consultation with Belfast. What's angered environmentalists, though, is that he's also taken issue with the content of the ads. Sammy Wilson doesn't believe climate change is caused by people.
We're completely furious about this. It's a totally irresponsible decision. We desperately need to reduce emissions in this country, across the country, and we've introduced a climate change bill to do so, which Sammy Wilson's party has actually voted for, and yet here he is standing up against it. It's totally irresponsible, and he needs to be sacked now.
It's not the first time the former mayor of Belfast has courted controversy. He once shared a joke about the Pope on comedian Ali G's TV show. But on climate change, he stands alone. Northern Ireland is now legally committed to the same carbon cuts as the rest of us.
Tom Clark. Well, earlier I spoke to Northern Ireland's Environment Secretary, Sammy Wilson, and I asked him why he refuses to believe climate change is a man-made problem.
I believe that the climate in the Earth continually changes, and indeed there have been changes right throughout the history of the Earth. I don't believe that those changes are due to CO2 emissions, or indeed that is a major contributor to those changes. And of course this has become a major obsession with this government, which now spends thousands of millions of pounds of taxpayers' money, which regulates individuals, which restricts what individuals can do, and which of course as a result has increased fuel costs, electricity costs, put up car taxes, all forms of unpopular policies. And of course, having done that, I suppose I've got to convince people that it's being done for some purpose.
But in short, you do not believe in man-made climate change.
No, I do not believe in man-made climate change. And of course, there's a wide body of political, economic and scientific opinion which takes the same view as I do.
Well, 95% of the world's leading 95% of the world's leading scientists, all the team that President Barack Obama has appointed, all the team in Whitehall, all the team in most of the European capitals are made up of people who have become completely convinced through research that man is playing a role in global warming.
Well, if you select the right people, of course, you'll get the answer that you want. You've also got to remember that surveys of climate scientists and others, those are scientists who actually have got some expertise in this, that there's a much greater division on opinion. And indeed, the last survey, I think, that was done of climate scientists indicated that about 43% of climate scientists were either convinced that man-made causes were not.
Or
some of them were not convinced.
Not a survey that's currently attracting very much respect. And surely nobody selected the 181 nations that signed up to the Kyoto Agreement on climate change. Presumably they're all wrong as well.
Well, they signed up for a whole variety of reasons, of course, but even those nations that did sign up to the Kyoto Protocol, many of them are indicating, and indeed are, some of them are not moving as fast as others because they know the implications that reducing CO2 emissions will have on their economies, on the displacement of jobs, and indeed on the costs for individuals who live within their countries.
Northern Ireland's Environment Minister Sammy Wilson talking to me earlier.